Polish radio, because the albums and the vinyl they're very, very expensive. I mean, an album costs about, you know, the average Polish worker's weekly wage. You know, everything's to tape. I mean, it's the only country I never object to people taping the albums. And when you go into a Polish radio station, there's no discs, everything's on reels. So you've got like 3.5 minute, 4 minute reels that you have a whole host of guys all changing these reels so the DJ can keep on talking, threading reels through. But there's, I mean, a lot of people think it's a very, you know, shut off country, you know, from a music point of view, but it's not. I mean, they're very, very aware of what's happening across in Germany and France and things. And I think, you know, rock music in general gets a lot more coverage in Poland than probably in anywhere else in Europe. And the fans at the gigs, I mean, they're so pleased you actually come there. The response is frightening. I mean, it's a bit like you see the old films of Beatlemania, and that actually happens in Poland. I mean, we were amazed when we were there, and you get on the bus, and we had 300 kids chasing the bus, and we went down one side of Joe Carnegie, we turned the bus around, and the kids ran across and lay down in the road in front of the bus to make us stop and sign autographs. And it's every time you come downstairs in the hotel, you've got at least 70 kids in the hotel, you know? I mean, if any band's ever thinking of going there, I'd thoroughly recommend it. We're going back there again in the next tour, and hopefully there's somebody from the Russian side came across and they want us to go into Russia. But I think it's great that, you know, music gets a chance to get across there. I mean, it breaks a lot of barriers that, you know, politicians and borders and stuff, you know, set up. And it gives a chance, you know, of mass communication.
And finally, for Backstage Pass, we asked Fish from Marillion about leisure time. What did he do most of the time while he was on tour? Or did he have any free time?
And the funny thing is, I remember seeing Charlie Watts in an interview with the Stones, and they were shooting a video. And, you know, he made a comment that, you know, most of his life spent hanging about. And I think that, you know, that is really what, you know, is in a band. I mean, because of the travelling to gigs. And I reckon, you know, 90 to 95% of your time is spent hanging about, waiting on things, waiting on planes or cars or gig times or whatever. I find that really tiring. I mean, your entire day is built up to the, you know, the hour and 45, 2 hours you're actually on stage. And I mean, that 2 hours is the equivalent of working a 12-hour shift. I mean, from, you know, a psychological perspective, from a physical perspective, it drains you, you know? I mean, you imagine that the conflict between, you know, the adrenaline and the tiredness, it can really sort of like visually screw you up. The average day, you could say, is like, you know, getting up around about 12 when, you know, the hotel throws you out. And then you travel to the gig, then you do your relevant interviews with local press, whatever. Then you sound check, and you hang about, you have something to eat, then you've got 2 hours, then the gig. And then it takes me, I think, you know, because you work in front, you tend to take an awful lot of energy from the audience as well. And it takes about 4 hours for you to disperse, you know, the power that you've been given for that over that 2 hour period. I mean, one of the things I've got into in this last tour, which I heard from another singer, was taking steam baths, which I find, you know, really relaxes the cords. So I've been going, I mean, it was great in Germany and France, you know, because I mean, everybody's becoming so health conscious nowadays. There's all these steam baths and saunas and things. So I go in there and I'll spend an hour in there. Actually, in the hotel in London, it was really funny today. So the maids came into the room and I found out I've got a tiny bathroom. And if I put the shower on full, I get one of the best steam baths you can possibly get. And I go and I sit, I put a towel on the ledge of where the washhand basin is, and I sit on the ledge with the steam on for about 45 minutes, an hour. And the maid came into the room today, and I'm walking out, and she's like, standing there, like this. There's water pouring through the walls, you know? So I think I'm going to get in a lot of shit tomorrow when I check out.
On the outskirts of-